Here, I have an obstacle course, and I'd like to create a checkpoint system so that should a player fall, they don't have to go back to the beginning of the course. Here's how I go about doing that. So, the first thing I'm going to do is create an object that will be the respawn point for the player. I'm going to come over to the hierarchy and go right-click and create an empty game object. I'm going to make this a child of my scene descriptor, mine's called VRC World, and I'm going to change its name to be respawn point and reset its transform. I'm then going to go into my scene descriptor and make this new empty game object the spawn point for the world. Awesome, so now all I need to do is move this object around the world to change where we respawn. So I'm going to create some checkpoints along my course to do so. To make the checkpoint, I'm going to come into the hierarchy and right-click 3D object cube. I'm going to call this checkpoint. I then want to fly to roughly where I want it to respawn the player and go Control Shift F to place it where I am. I'm then going to modify its position and rotation to be just right. Now I'm going to remove its mesh renderer as I don't want it to be visible, and now we essentially have an invisible wall. As I want the player to be able to walk inside of it, I'm going to come down to the box collider and hit is trigger and make that true. Then I'm going to hit this little button here to edit its collider. This collider will determine when the player has made it to the checkpoint, so I'm going to make it large enough to activate anywhere on this platform. Now that we have the trigger sorted, we need to give this checkpoint some logic. I'm going to come down and go add component, Udon behavior. Now we need to create a script to go inside this Udon behavior component, so I'm going to come into my project window, right click and go create VRChat Udon Udon graph program asset. And I'm going to name it checkpoint logic. And now I'm going to open up the Udon graph. Now that we have the Udon graph open, I want to come over to this variables tab and hit this little plus button, and we want to create a transform. I'm going to call this respawn object and hit this little drop down menu to make it public so we can select it inside the inspector. Then, coming into the graph, we want to right click create node, the shortcut for this is spacebar, and go transform, set position and rotation. This node requires three inputs, a transform that will be moved, and a position and rotation for where we want to move it, represented as a vector free and quaternion respectively. We want to drag and drop our respawn object into the graph and plug that into the instance slot. Then we want to create a transform get position node and plug that into the position slot. We also want a transform get rotation node and plug that into the rotation slot. Now, game object and transform nodes by default will grab the game object that they are on. So instead of us having to plug a this node into a game object get transform node and plugging that into the instance slot, we can leave the slot blank and avoid the hassle. So now, whenever this node is called, it will set our respawn object's position and rotation to be the same as the game object that this script is on. Now, we just need to say when we want this node to be called. To do so, we want to create an onPlayerTriggerEnter node, and this node will be called whenever a player walks into the trigger. Now, we only wanted to change the respawn point if we, the local player, enter the trigger, so we want to check for that. So, we want to grab this player API and put that through a player API getIsLocal node. This node will give us a bool that will equal true if it's the local player and false if it's not. We then want to put that into a branch node and plug the true into our set position node. So now, whenever a player enters the trigger, it will check to see whether or not that player is the local player. And only if they are the local player will it play this node. Awesome, so coming back into our scene view, we want to click on our checkpoint. We want to drag and drop our new script into the Udon behavior component. And then we want to come up into our respawn point object and drag that into the script. So now, it's time to test this. So now that I'm in the world, if I was to jump off right at the start, we see that I respawn normally. But if I was to come over here and over to my checkpoint and then jump off, when I jump off, I respawn at the checkpoint. Awesome! So now, this is all well and good, but to spice things up a bit, what if we wanted to create some dev blocks that respawn the player should you touch them? To do so, I'm first going to create another cube by going into my hierarchy, right clicking and going 3D object cube. I'm then going to fly around and go Control Shift F to place it where I am, and then adjust its size and position and rotation to be just right. I'm then going to come down to its box collider and set is trigger to equal true. And finally, to give it some logic, I'm going to go add component Udon behavior. And now it's time to make a script to go inside this Udon behavior component. To create the script, I'm going to go to my current script and go Control D to duplicate it, and change its name to player def box. And now I'm going to open up the Udon graph. Now, unfortunately, as far as I know, there is currently no way to tell the player to respawn. That being said, however, if we teleport the player to be below the point of respawn, we can force the player to respawn. It is a slightly hacky way of doing this, but hey, it works. So now that I'm in the graph, I'm going to delete my variable here as we won't be needing it. I also want to delete everything after this branch node. So now, whenever the local player touches the trigger, we want to teleport them to be below the world. I want to go create node player API teleport to get a node that will teleport the player. This node requires a player to teleport, so I'm going to go networking get local player and plug that into the instance slot. Now, we just need to say where we want the player to teleport to. And as we just want to teleport the player really low to get them to respawn, I'm going to change this Y node to be something really low. I'm going to go -999, and as -100 is the default respawn height, this value should be fine in most cases. So now, whenever this node is called, it will grab the local player and tell them to teleport to this location. That location should be below the respawn point, causing the player to respawn. So now, all we need to do is plug the true from the branch node into this arrow slot, and it will play this node whenever the local player touches this object. Neat. However, there is one more thing that we need to do. Normally when a player respawns, it's because they fell out of the world. This, however, isn't always the case when a player triggers the script. So, if you were to jump up into this death box and get respawned, you will have an upwards velocity when you respawn, flinging you from the respawn point. So, to avoid this, all we need to do is reset the player's velocity when we respawn them. To do so, after the teleport to node, we want to create a player API set velocity node. With this, we want to grab the local player again and put that into the instance slot. So now, whenever this node is called, it will set the local player's velocity to the value down here, to which we have set to 0. So now, if we hit compile and come back into our scene view, we can select our cube and give it the new script. Now it's time to test this. So now that we're in the world, when we jump into the box, we see that it respawns the player. Awesome! Now, coming back into our respawn script, what if we want it to be networked so that if one player completes the level, everyone continues from that point onwards? Well, to do that, first we want to come into our hierarchy and select our respawn point. In the inspector, we want to go add component object synced. With this object sync component, it will update the position for everyone in the scene as well as latecomers. Unfortunately, now only the owner of the object can change its position, so we need to make some slight changes to our script. Coming back into the script, we can come into the graph and go create node custom event. I'm going to call it checkpoint reach, and we're going to plug that into the arrow slot of the set position and rotation node. Then we want to grab the true from our branch node, and we instead want to put that into an Udon behavior send custom networked event. We want to select the target to be the owner, as only the owner can move the object. Then, for the event name, we just want to hit this little drop-down menu and select our custom event. So now, whenever the local player enters the trigger, it will tell the owner to play this event. That owner will then play this event, moving the object, and as the object has an object synced component on it, it will in turn mean everyone will see it move, updating the respawn point for everyone. Awesome! So now if we hit compile and build and test this with two instances, we can see that when one person enters the collider, it updates for the other players as well. Awesome! Anyways, hopefully that was helpful for you. Feel free to leave a like on the video if you liked it, leave a comment down below if you have any questions, and feel free to check out some of my other tutorials that I have on the channel. But until next time, bye!